I want to find out more about Curtis Island, and in particular, how Australia Pacific LNG is reducing its effect on the environment. With its gas plant nearing completion, I decided to get out on the water to see the island for myself. I'm then taking a flight around the gas plant with project manager Ken Anderson to get his take on the safeguards in place and the environmental offsets being undertaken.
This is Australia Pacific LNG right here on the left. You can see our storage tanks, our ground flares, and our two LNG trains.
What happens when the gas hits Curtis Island?
Gas comes in over on the far east side of the facility and comes down this pipeline, runs through what we call the LNG train, and we chill it to minus 161 degrees C, and we pump it into those big storage tanks until we get a ship in.
What are the risks, you know, when you're loading up one of these tankers?
We've designed that facility very carefully. If there's an issue with the ship and we have to break away, those loading arms are made to break away very quickly.
Is there any requirements for you to offset what you've done?
Well, there is. So the three proponents actually take up a pretty small amount of Curtis Island, about 3% altogether. And the three proponents have gotten together and purchased some offsets on the other end of Curtis Island that amount to about 44% of the island.
And what do you see the future of Curtis Island, Gladstone, and the LNG industry here?
This will be a strong industry for the region for a long time, employ a lot of people.
To truly get an understanding of Gladstone Harbour, I'm going to visit Captain John Fallon, the Gladstone Harbour Master, and tour the new Vessel Tracking Service Centre. I want to see how the gas ships we managed in the harbour and find out what's being done to protect the Great Barrier Reef.
Hey, John.
Darren, welcome to Maritime Safety Queensland's Gladstone office.
How do you keep track of all the vessels when there's that many movements and also make sure everyone stays safe?
Next door, if you want to follow us, we've got a control room, which is the Vessel Traffic Services control room. Now, this is the Gladstone VTS area and where we control all the ships in the harbour. There's three operators that work 24 hours a day, 7 days a week here.
The LNG tankers are going to be coming soon, and I guess when will be the peak impact of that?
It's going to slowly build up. The first plant kicks off fairly soon, and that'll be the first shipping coming in, but the maximum will be early 2016. At that stage, we'll have around about 8 movements a week.
Do they bring a new risk?
Not really, no. To us, they're just ships and they're coming and going. We will, however, have tugboats with them all the way out to the entrance to the harbour, and they escort them all the way in and then all the way out when they go, which we don't do with the coal carriers at the moment. So that's one area where we have boosted the safety for them coming in and out.
A lot of the public worry about the impact that the LNG industry is going to have on the Great Barrier Reef.
We've taken into account all the risks involved, and the ships that are coming and going are positively controlled any time they're inside the reef. So an LNG ship, when it leaves Gladstone Harbour, will go out of the harbour with a pilot on board and two tugboats escorting it until it gets out to this area here. And then once it's there and the pilot gets off, it takes over Reef VTS. They take control of the ship then until it's outside the reef.
Thanks,
Darren, thanks for coming along.
Very impressive.
Appreciate it. Any time you've got to come back and have a look, feel free.